So today we're looking at ratios, and you're wondering, what's the big deal? You've been doing ratios probably since you were in primary school, and you looked at little patterns like this, where clearly the ratio would be 1:3:4. Well, there's clearly a little bit of work that we need to do on it, because it's one of the things that students get wrong again and again and again in A-level questions. So let's just go through what it is we need to say. Firstly, we need this colon in there. So when you write your ratio, it's not like this, it's not like this, it's with the colon. Nothing difficult about that. The other thing is that we need to make sure that we're always, the ratio is always something to one, okay? So I know it's clunky, but sometimes, for example, if you were measuring the heights of pea plants and you had this kind of ratio, that is not your final answer. You have to change that as something to one. And the easiest way to do that is to look at this number 7. 7 divided by 7 is 1. 12 then divided by 7 is 1.74. And 13 divided by 7 is 1.86. Now, it looks clunky, and it is. You probably wouldn't get those numbers in a question, but you can definitely get decimals. And remember, when we're dealing with decimals, we're always working to three significant figures. So that's the first thing. The second thing that we're doing is sometimes we're getting our ratios the wrong way around. So for example, it will deliberately give you numbers like this. If we're comparing males and females, we might have 24 and 23, and it will say, what are the ratio of males to females? So you've got to get that the right way around. And you might think it is less clunky to write it like this, but it's got to be to one. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna divide 23 by 23 to get one. We're gonna divide 24 by 23, and we get 1.04, again, to three significant figures. And hopefully, if we remember the colon, if we remember the right way round, if we remember to always do it to one, we're gonna get the marks at A level.